So I have the polynomial p of x here, and p of x is being expressed as a fourth degree polynomial times 3x minus 8 squared. So this would actually give you some, you know, this would give you 9x squared and a bunch of other stuff, and then you multiply that times this, it would actually give you a sixth degree polynomial all in all. But our goal is to find the x values where that makes p of x equal to 0. Or another way, find the roots or the zeros of this polynomial. And in particular, we're going to focus on the real zeros, or the real roots of this polynomial. And like always, I encourage you to give a go at it, and then we'll do it together. All right, let's tackle this. So the way I want to solve p of x is equal to 0. I want to solve p of x is equal to 0 and figure out what, and when I say solve it, I want to say, well, what x values will make the polynomial equal to 0? So I just need to set this right-hand side to be equal to 0 and then solve for x. And the best way I can think of doing that is by factoring this out as much as I can. And if I can, rewrite it as a product of a bunch of expressions equaling 0, well, if you have a product of a bunch of things equaling 0, you can make it equal 0 by any one of them equaling 0. And so let's do that. So 3x minus 8 squared, this is already factored quite nicely. Let's see if we can factor, all this business in. If we can factor all of this business in white. And the way I will tackle it is see if I can factor by grouping. So let me group together these first two terms, and then let me group together these second two terms. And essentially, factoring by grouping is doing the distributive property in reverse twice. So from these first two terms, I could factor out. Let's see, what could I factor out? I could factor out a, let me see. I'll just factor out an x to the third power. So I get x to the third power times 3x minus 8. Interesting, we had a 3x minus 8 over there as well. Now these second two terms, I could factor out a 5. So it's going to be plus 5 times x. Times 3x, 3x minus 8, very interesting. And of course, I have these parentheses around all of that, and then I have 3x minus 8 squared. This 3x minus 8 is showing up a lot. And so, and of course, this is going to be equal to 0. It's going to be equal to 0. And now I can factor out a 3x minus 8 over here. I could factor that 3x minus 8 out, and I'm going to get 3x minus 8 times x to the third power, plus 5. Once again, I just factored out a 3x minus 8 plus 5. Close the parentheses. And then times 3x minus 8 squared is all going to be equal to 0. Now, if what I just did looks a little bit like voodoo, just realize I have two terms. Both of them are multiples of 3x minus 8. I just factored out the 3x minus 8. I did the distributive property in reverse, so I factored it out. And what you're left with, this term, you're just left with an x to the third. And then this term, you're just left with a plus 5. Now, I have 3x minus 8 times x to the third plus 5 times 3x minus 8 squared. Well, I could just rewrite this as I have as 3x minus 8 to the third power times x to the third plus 5. So let me do that. So I can just rewrite this as 3x minus 8 to the third power. That's that times that. And then times, let me do this in a nicer color, times x to the third plus 5 is equal to 0, And now, in order to get this to be equal to 0, either this thing is going to be equal to 0, or this thing over here is going to be equal to 0. So let's first think about 3x minus 8 to the third power equaling 0. So I could write this as 3x minus 8 to the third power is equal to 0, or x to the third plus 5 is equal to 0. So to make 3x minus 8 to the third power equal 0, well, that means that 3x minus 8 is going to be equal to 0, or that 3x is equal to 8. Divide both sides by 3, x is equal to 8/3. So that's one way to make this polynomial equal 0. X is equal to 8/3. In fact, just this right over here will become 0. 0 times anything is 0. So this is a 0 of our polynomial. And let's see. So x to the third, so we could say if we subtract 5 from both sides, we have x to the third is equal to negative 5. And so if we take both to the 1/3 power, we could say x is equal to the cube root of negative 5. Now at first you might say, hey, can I take a cube root of a negative number? And I would say, of course you can. The cube root of negative 1 is negative 1. The cube root of negative 8 is negative 2. In fact, you could, even if we're dealing with reals, this is going to be a negative number. This is not going to be an imaginary number right over here. And so these are the two zeros of the polynomial. This is going to be negative, I think, negative 1 point something. Actually, we could figure it out exactly. So let's raise, do they have cube root on this? No, let's raise 5 to the, open parentheses, 1 divided by 3, close parentheses, is equal to, so that's 5 to the 1/3, so negative 5 to the 1/3 power is going to be negative 1.71 approximately. So this is approximately equal to negative 1.71. So we have two real roots to this polynomial, or two real zeros for this polynomial. And so those are going to be the two places where we intercept the x-axis, the two x values for which, where, or the two places where we intercept the x-axis, I guess is the easiest way to say it.